Bonjour, bonjour everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril, I have been a stem cell researcher for quite some time and this is why I can tell you about the science that is behind skincare ingredients. And for today's video, I'm going to answer a very hot topic, which is do you need to wear sunscreen when you are at home? So I've been asked this question for quite a lot, especially on Instagram, is do I need to wear my sunscreen when I am at home? And always my answer is it depends, and I think it is really worth that I made a whole video about it. And I'm going to quote Paula Bigoun. She said that it's important to be sun smart, and I really love this quote. So, to make this video really easy and I would say straightforward, I'm just going to give you three different situations for you to understand. So the first scenario is you are, for example, living in an environment where you basically don't have a lot of the light. So I'm thinking of you, Peter, who apparently you live in nowhere. Obviously, if you live in a really northern country, especially during winter, you basically have something like 3 to 4 hours of daylight, so you are not going to be exposed to a lot of UV, especially when you are going to be at home. So in those conditions, you don't need to wear a sunscreen. Another situation, like myself during summer when I am in Paris, most of the time live with all the shutters completely closed and also the curtain to prevent any sunlight to come in, especially because of the heat. And therefore, I am not going to be exposed to any UV light, hence why you definitely don't need to have a sunscreen. It also could be that you simply choose to live with your curtain closed for whatever reason. So basically, when you don't have sunlight that goes into your home, it's completely fine to not wear sunscreen. So the second situation is, of course, the complete opposite. You live in a house with a lot of windows, you are basking into sunlight, and here obviously you do need to have a sunscreen, there is no doubt about this. And I want to remind you that in most cases through windows only UVB are stopped, but the UVA and especially the UVA type 1, so the ones that are the closest to the blue light that we can see with our eyes, are the most damaging in terms of aging, and they are the ones that age us like crazy. So it is very important to wear a sunscreen in those situations. So the third scenario is, I would say, a mix between the one and the two. So to give you an example, and this is something that happens to me, like I said, especially in summer, but also sometimes in winter. What about in that, for example, in the morning I'm going to let the light shine on in my apartment, and in that case I will need to slather myself with sunscreen, but most of the time during the afternoon I'm just going to close the shutters but also all the curtain. So in that case I am just not going to reapply the sunscreen. Now, it also could be the other way around, you close everything during the morning when you are there, and then during the afternoon you want to have some light, and in that case you will need to apply sunscreen. But like Paula Bigoun said, be sun smart. As soon as you are exposed to visible light for more than basically 1 minute, you do need to have a sunscreen. Now, what type of sunscreen can you use at home? In general, with sunscreen, I do promote to have what I call two types of sunscreen. The one that are, I would say, the daily sunscreen, so they are still SPF 50+, because I will never recommend you a sunscreen under SPF 50+, for sure, but they have much more elegant texture compared to other ones that are what I call very hardcore sunscreen. Usually they also comes with the cons, so the texture is a little bit greasier, it is less easy to work with it, so you basically have to twist your whole routine to make them work. That can have a white cast. I mean, there is a plethora of, I would say, problem and issues with them that I'm definitely willing to recommend you and to use them when you are going to be exposed to a lot of sun. But when you stay at home, most of the time you are not going to stay all day long just in front of your windows like that, and therefore you can definitely use a sunscreen that don't necessarily have the perfect combination of filters, but that are extremely elegant to wear and that doesn't feel like sunscreen. So my two recommendations that will not come as a surprise for you, especially if you're not new to my channel, is the Clary Gloss of Terry UV Essence, or another one that is almost a dupe of this one, which is this one from the Korean brand Purito. This is the Centella Green Level Anti-Aging Sun. I have a skincare battle on those two if you exactly want to know what is the difference between the two. Just keep in mind that this one has an essential oils derived from mandarin, if I'm not mistaken. It is probably very minimum because you really barely smell it, so I don't even understand why they put it in here. And it also doesn't linger on the skin, but be aware of that, especially if you have sensitive skin. Definitely the Clarins is probably not a good option. What is fantastic about this one is that it only uses two UV filters, so they are very gentle for the skin. Also the texture, they just don't feel like sunscreen basically, so they are very elegant. My last point is going to be on reapplication. So I invite you to watch my video on the AV sunscreen and why you will not buy it, because I talk about one specific papers that talk about the persistence of the SPF. So basically, especially when you are at home, because the UV exposure will not be that high, I don't recommend to reapply it like every 2 hours. In general, I reapply it 3 to 4 hours after. And most of the time what I do, I only do one application per day, because I always manage when I stay at home to have at least all my curtains completely closed, so I'm not exposed to UV light, for example, in the morning, but only in the afternoon, and this is only the time where I'm going to reapply the sunscreen. And currently in Paris, around 5:30 or something like that, the sun starts to go down. So basically, I don't need to reapply, so it's very convenient for those there. Obviously, if you are going to stay a long time outside, even in winter, you do need to reapply your sunscreen, and probably to choose an even better protection. So comment down below and tell me if you have any questions. If you like this video, please thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to ring the little bell to not miss any of my new videos and to see more of my dog. His name is Guabao. You can also follow me on Instagram. I am Cyril Laurent. I have a lot of content here that is not necessarily the same as on YouTube. I thank you so much for watching me, and I will see you next time. Au revoir. Bye bye.